Ladies and gentlemen, as you watch this ministry unfold tonight, I ask you to look at it through the eyes of, there's no union card, there's no Screen Actors Guild involved, there's no professional actors or actresses here. I ask you to see it through the eyes of your heart, your spiritual eyes, to know that each member of this cast tonight, this is a ministry, and it's a ministry to each and every one of us through the Lord Jesus Christ. And as that ministry goes, I ask that you see the heart of those people that so faithfully give to the Lord and how we benefit for our encouragement and our edification tonight. I ask that you see the ministry, the true story that they present through this drama tonight and what God did for us in giving us a Savior in Jesus Christ. I ask that you see the potential, not only in what happens when we have a Savior in Jesus Christ, but how we build upon that in our Christian lives in serving our Lord Jesus Christ. And I'm proud to say, as the pastor of the New Testament Baptist Church, that in the Lord reverentially, I'm proud of the ministry that is directed by Chuck and Ruth Dennison. And I'm proud of the servants, the faithful servants, that knit their hearts together in one accord, despite the differences of humanity, to come together for the Lord Jesus Christ to present his story. I ask that you silence all electronic devices, telephones, cell phones, Twitter devices, whatever the case may be, as this is a reverential time tonight. It is not a drama to be entertained by, but it is here to minister to the saints for the Lord Jesus Christ tonight. I proudly present to you the promise fulfilled.
The story of Christmas is one of mystery and intrigue. Although a deliverer was first promised in the early chapters of Genesis, the theme of a Savior and Redeemer continued to unfold throughout the Old Testament until it actually reached the birth of Christ in the New Testament. We hope the old, old story of Jesus and his love will come alive for you in a new and different way than ever before.
Oh, come, all ye faithful, joyful and triumphant, O come ye to Bethlehem. Come and behold him, born the King of angels. O come, let us adore him. O come, let us adore him. O come, let us adore him, Christ the Lord. Yea, Lord, we greet thee, born this happy morning. Jesus, to thee be our glory given. Word of the Father, now in flesh appearing. O come, let us adore him. O come, let us adore him. O come, let us adore him, Christ the Lord.
For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulder, and his name shall be called Wonderful, Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace.
I'm Isaiah. I lived some 700 years before the birth of Jesus. But I have a part in this story because of a message that God gave to me. Part of that message was about the promised Messiah. God told me that a virgin would have a baby boy and that he would be called Emmanuel, which means God with us, and that he would be the Savior and the Redeemer of the world. A virgin, I thought to myself. A young, unmarried woman that had preserved the purity of her body have a baby? How could that be? But it wasn't for me to question or to reason, just believe. God also told me that the Messiah would come through the family of Jesse. Now, you remember Jesse. He was the father of King David. Well, God promised the Messiah, and he kept his promise. Even though it took some 700 years for the world to realize the fulfillment of the prophecy, yet, in the fullness of time, it came to pass just as he promised. God always keeps his promise.
Child one day, and the sky was bright with the holy light for the place where Jesus lay. Hallelujah! Oh, how the angels sang! Hallelujah! How it rang! And the sky was bright with the holy light. 'Twas the birthday of the King. Let us adore him. Oh, come, let us adore him. Oh, come, let us adore him. Christ the Lord. 'Twas a humble birthplace, but oh, how much God gave to us that day. From a manger bed, what a path was led, what a perfect holy way. Hallelujah! Oh, how the angels sang! Hallelujah! How it rang! And the sky was bright with the holy light. 'Twas the birthday of the King. Hallelujah! Oh, how the angels sang! Hallelujah! How it rang! And the sky was bright with the holy light. 'Twas the birthday of the Savior. Hallelujah! Hallelujah! 'Twas the birthday of the King.
And in the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent from God into a city of Galilee named Nazareth, to a virgin espoused to a man whose name was Joseph of the house of David, and the virgin's name was Mary. And the angel came in unto her and said, Hail, thou that art highly favored, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women. And when she saw him, she was troubled at his saying, and cast in her mind what manner of salutation this should be. And the angel said unto her, Fear not, Mary, for thou hast found favor with God. And behold, thou shalt conceive in thy womb and bring forth a son, and shalt call his name Jesus. He shall be great, and shall be called the Son of the Highest. And the Lord God shall give unto him the throne of his father David, and he shall reign over the house of Jacob forever. And of this kingdom there shall be no end. Then said Mary unto the angel, How shall this be, seeing I know not a man? And the angel answered and said unto her, The Holy Ghost shall come upon thee, and the power of the highest shall overshadow thee. Therefore, also that holy thing which shall be born of thee shall be called the Son of God. For with God nothing shall be impossible. And Mary said, Behold, the handmaid of the Lord, be it unto me according to thy word. And the angel departed from her.
Oh, you are more perfect than I ever could have imagined, my little one. I can hardly believe you are here, right now in my arms. It seems as though this journey has taken forever, and yet only just begun, all at the same time. I was so afraid when the angel first told me about you. Finding out I was great with child was shocking to me. People who didn't understand, they thought I was involved in some sort of scandal. And there were moments I feared for our future. But all that is behind us now. You are a very special child in ways I cannot understand yet. And there is much I am uncertain of. I am young and know little about caring for a child. The promised Messiah that all of Israel has prayed for is here today, and I am his mother. The knowledge is sometimes too great for me to bear. Oh, precious Jesus, I wonder every day why God chose me to be your mother. I wonder, but never regret. I don't know what the future holds for us, little one, but I do know I will do my best to raise you.
Did you know that your baby boy will one day walk on water? Mary, did you know that your baby boy would save our sons and daughters? Did you know that your baby boy has come to make you new? This child that you delivered will soon deliver you. Mary, did you know that your baby boy would give sight to a blind man? Mary, did you know that your baby boy would calm a storm with his hand? Did you know that your baby boy has walked where angels trod? When you kiss your little baby, you've kissed the face of God. The blind will see, the deaf will hear, and the dead will live again. The lame will leap, the dumb will speak, the praises of the Lamb. Mary, did you know that your baby boy is Lord of all creation? Mary, did you know that your baby boy would one day rule the nation? Did you know that your baby boy was heaven's perfect lamb. This sleeping child you're holding is the great I am.
Now the birth of Jesus Christ was on this wise. When as his mother Mary was espoused to Joseph, before they came together, she was found with child of the Holy Ghost. Then Joseph, her husband, being a just man and not willing to make her a public example, was minded to put her away privily. But while he thought on these things, behold, the angel of the Lord appeared unto him in a dream, saying, Joseph, thou son of David, fear not to take unto thee Mary thy wife, for that which is conceived in her is of the Holy Ghost. And she shall bring forth a son, and thou shalt call his name Jesus, for he shall save his people from their sins. Now all of this was done that it might be fulfilled, which was spoken of the Lord by the prophet, saying, Behold, a virgin shall be with child, and shall bring forth a son, and they shall call his name Emmanuel, which being interpreted is God with us. Then Joseph, being raised from sleep, did as the angel of the Lord had bidden him, and took unto him his wife.
When I first heard about the baby, I was angry. I was angry at Mary for getting pregnant. I was angry at God for letting it happen. And I was angry at myself. I couldn't give her away. It would be the end of her reputation and maybe even her life. One night an angel appeared to me in a dream, and he told me not to be afraid. He said that this child was God's child and that he had chosen my fiance to carry the promised Messiah, and he had chosen me to be his earthly parent. The first time I seen God's child, he was a tiny, helpless baby in the arms of my young wife, needing all the care and attention that this incapable parent could give him. And yet, he is my Savior. I know I can never compare to his Father God, but I'm going to do my best to be the parent that he needs here on earth.
Must have been surprised where this road had taken him, 'cause never in a million lives could he have dreamed of Bethlehem. And standing at the manger, he saw with his own eyes the message from the angel come to light. And Joseph said, why me? I'm just a simple man of trade. Why him with all the rulers in the world? Why here? Inside this stable filled with hay, why her? She's just an ordinary girl. Now I'm not one to second guess what angels have to say, but this is such a strange way to save the world. Thank you. to think of how it could have been if Jesus had come as he deserved. There would have been no Bethlehem, no lowly strangers at his birth. But Joseph knew the reason love had to reach so far. And as he held the Savior in his arms, he must have thought, why me? I'm just a simple man of trade. Why him with all the rulers in the world? Why here inside this table filled with hay? Why her? She's just an ordinary girl. Now I'm not one to second guess what angels have to say, but this is such a strange way to save the world. Now I'm not one to second guess what angels have to say, but this is such a strange way to save the world. Such a strange way. A strange way. Strange way to save.
And behold, thy cousin Elizabeth, she hath also conceived a son in her old age. And this is the sixth month with her, and she was also called barren. And Mary arose in those days and went into the hill country with haste, into a city of Judah, and entered into the house of Zacharias, and saluted Elizabeth.
To this nativity story, I am Elizabeth. I am the cousin of Mary and the wife of Zachariah. My husband is a Jewish priest and a member of the Temple Service Corps. But this great honor was marred by us being childless. You see, my neighbors would go behind my back and whisper, "She who is called barren." But in our old age, a miracle occurred that would change our lives forever. An angel appeared to Zechariah and told him that God had heard and answered his prayers. And Zechariah chose not to believe the angel. And because Zechariah did, he was stricken silent and unable to speak until our child was born. But 6 months later, Mary came to visit me. And my unborn child, he leaped within me, and I was filled with the Holy Spirit. And I knew at that very moment that God had chosen my Mary, my sweet cousin Mary, to be the mother of the Messiah. Mary stayed with me for 3 months before returning home. Our time had finally come, and our precious baby boy was born. And in accordance to the angel's instructions, We named him John. And oh yes, just as the angel had said, my husband did regain his power of speech. How honored and blessed I am to be the mother of a very special child, a child who would be the forerunner for the Messiah.
And it came to pass in those days that there went out a decree from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be taxed, and all went to be taxed, everyone into his own city. And Joseph also went up from Galilee, out of the city of Nazareth, into Judea, unto the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and lineage of David, to be taxed with Mary, his espoused wife, and being great with child. And so it was that while they were there, the days were accomplished that she should be delivered. And she brought forth her firstborn son, and wrapped him in swaddling clothes, and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn.
Oh, little town of Bethlehem, how could you have known that the Son of God would be born in your midst on that holy night? How could any of us have known? People had traveled from afar to register to pay their taxes. All day long, knocks came upon our heavy door, and all day long, we made room for weary travelers within. But now, night had fallen, and our inn was full. Not one bed remained. It was then, with darkness all around, another knock came, insistent and desperate. My husband went to see who could possibly be seeking shelter at this late hour. I heard the door, and then I heard a voice pleading, "Please, please, can you make room for us?" My husband simply explained there was no room. And then I heard a sound. A moan, a deep moan from a woman. I knew this was the sound of a woman in labor. And then I saw her slumped over and riding on the back of a donkey. We knew we had to make room for this young couple, so we led them to the stable because it was all the room that we had. It was there that night in a dirty, filthy animal shelter, greatly resembling the human hearts he had come to cleanse. Jesus entered humanity. Jesus, that's the baby's name. We learned this later that night from shepherds who came in from the field. Oh, what a story they told. The heavens opened up and angels proclaimed the birth of God's own son. Go to Bethlehem, they said, and you will find him lying in a manger. In a manger. In our manger. For there was simply no room in our inn.
And there were in the same country shepherds abiding in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night. And lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them, and the glory of the Lord shone round about them. And they were sore afraid. And the angel said unto them, "Fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord. And this shall be a sign unto you, ye shall find the babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger." And suddenly there was with this angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men."
Oh,
stars are brightly shining. It is the night of our dear Savior's birth. Long lay the world in sin and error pining, till he appeared and the soul felt its worth. The thrill of hope, the weary world rejoices, for yonder breaks a new and glorious morn. Slave is our brother, and in his name all oppression shall cease. Sweet hymns of joy in grateful adoration, let all within us praise his holy name. Christ is the Lord. Let ever, ever praise thee. Noel, Noel, oh,
of glory, we have come, multitudes and multitudes of us, to announce the birth of God's only Son. This is good news of great joy. Behold this sight. And look there, can you see it? Underneath the edge of the night sky, a great veil has been pulled back to reveal heaven to earth. And the witnesses to this great glory with the lowly, lowly shepherds. Funny, isn't it? It's funny how God will exalt the lowest of the low. Remember this, never forget. It is the humble, not the proud, who will find favor with the Almighty. And on the hillsides of Bethlehem that night, great favor was shown to those shepherds. Who would have known? The King of Kings has been born. And the throne of God directed us to herald the news, not in palaces, not to the political or the powerful, but in the middle of the night, in the middle of a field, to a group of people who didn't measure up to the middle class in the eyes of society. He has come. The Savior of the world has come. Hear the news. I bring you joy, bring you news of great joy, which is for all people. And the news is for you personally, for you and you and you and you and you. And you. And you. And you. For all of you. The Savior has come. For he is the Christ, and he is the Lord.
And it came to pass, as the angels were gone away from them into heaven, the shepherds said one to another, Let us now go even unto Bethlehem and see this thing which has come to pass, which the Lord had made known to us. And they came with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the babe lying in a manger. And when they had seen it, they made known abroad the saying which was told them concerning this child. And all they that heard it wondered at those things which were told them by the shepherds.
Shepherds watch, listening to lambs bleat, tired backs, worn out and cold feet, all life long, living like outcast, and all life long, living for life. A dazzling light, the voice of an angel, gripped with fear, terrified they felt, one like a man, yet awesome and holy, a face so fierce, and yet strangely kind. Do not be afraid, I've good news of great joy. Your Savior has come, He's Christ the Lord. As a sign to you, the one born today will be wrapped in rags, asleep on the hay. And all at once, the air filled with angels, glory shone, filling the night sky, glory be to God in the highest, and peace on earth to all those He loves. Do not be afraid, I've good news of great joy. Your Savior has come, He is Christ the Lord. as a sign to you. The one born today will be wrapped in rags, asleep on the hay. As a sign to you, the one born today will be wrapped in rags, asleep on the hay.
We went out, we told it in the mountains, we told it in the valley, and we told it in the hillsides. But first we told it in Bethlehem. We told them how Jesus Christ had come. We told them of the angels, thousands of them, and how the sky split open and there they were. I was horrified at first. One of the angels said unto me not to be afraid. Then the next thing he said was simply glorious. He said that a Savior had been born and we would find him lying in a manger. So off to Bethlehem we went. But I wonder what Mary thought when we got there. She probably didn't expect the welcoming committee to be the bottom rung of the social ladder. Today they would say we were from the wrong side of town. But there we were, chosen by God himself to be the first to look upon his son. What a wonderful message God sent to the world upon our arrival. You see, Jesus Christ had come for such as us, the lonely, the misfits, the rejected, and the ignored. Eternally, everyone would be welcome into his presence. There was no room in the inn, but Jesus said all who called upon his name would be welcomed, even us, even all of you.
Now, when Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea, in the days of Herod the king, behold, there came wise men from the east to Jerusalem, saying, "Where is he that is born king of the Jews? For we have seen his star in the east and are come to worship him." When they had heard the king, they departed, and lo, the star which they saw in the east went before them till it came and stood over where the young child was. And when they saw the star, they rejoiced with exceeding great joy. And when they were come into the house, they saw the young child with Mary, his mother, and fell down and worshipped him. And when they had opened their treasures, they presented unto him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh.
O star of wonder, star of night, we first saw your glorious rising in the east. And from the east, we followed your guiding to Bethlehem. We traveled until we reached Jerusalem first. Here at the palace of Herod, we inquired about the king we sought. Surely the palace would be the obvious place to look. Our question was a simple one. Where is he? Our reason to find him was equally as simple. We had come to worship him. We were determined to kneel before the King of Kings. We never expected that the king would not be in a palace, but instead entered humanity in the last place anyone would have expected to find him, a barn. And when we did find him, we humbly offered our gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. We came to honor him. We sought him, as the wise still do. And all of you here can humbly offer the greatest gift anyone could give him. Your hearts.
And behold, there was a man in Jerusalem whose name was Simeon. And the same man was just and devout, waiting for the consolation of Israel, and the Holy Ghost was upon him. And it was revealed to him by the Holy Ghost that he should not see death before he had seen the Lord's Christ.
I'm a small player in the nativity story.
In fact, I wasn't part of the story at all until the baby Jesus was about 6 weeks old. I first met the Christ child in the temple after his redemption ceremony. That's where the parents give their child to God by handing him to the priest, and the priest pronounces a benediction. I had heard from the shepherds that the Messiah was born in Bethlehem. I stayed around the temple for years waiting to see the Messiah, and God assured me that I should not see death until I had seen him with my own eyes. When I first saw the child, I trembled with excitement. At first, I could not speak. When I reached for the child, they gave him to me. And my heart was filled with joy. God had fulfilled his promise to Israel and to me. My life was now complete. I could die in peace.
And there was one Anna, a prophetess, the daughter of Phanuel of the tribe of Aser, and she was of great age. She was a widow of about 84 years, and departed not from the temple. And she coming in that instant gave thanks likewise to the Lord, and spake of him to all them that looked for redemption in Jerusalem.
I'm also a small player in the actual nativity story. I'm old now and a widow. I had only been married 7 short years before God took my husband from me. But God's my source of strength. I went to the temple day after day to pray for the coming of the Messiah. And even though he seemed to tarry, I waited for him patiently. I was in the temple that day and I saw Simeon. And he was holding a baby in his arms. And he began to praise God in the middle of the court. First, I didn't understand. But you see, God had told Simeon that he would not die until he had seen the Messiah. Then I saw the child for myself. And I knew it was true. This child is indeed the Messiah. Oh, I had waited for what seemed like an eternity for God's promise to be fulfilled. And then hope came in the form of a baby and changed the world forever. Now I too am ready to depart in peace to be joined once again with my husband.
And we share the same expectancy of the Messiah as did Simeon and Anna. Our expectancy of the Lord's coming, however, is not the expectancy of a Savior and Deliverer of the world, but of the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords as he comes in clouds of glory to gather his own to himself. And as day follows day, may we, as the shepherds and the wise men did, seek the Savior of mankind and fall at his feet in endless praise and adoration as we worship him from a heart of ceaseless gratitude.
I've heard about this baby boy who came to earth to bring us joy, and I just wanna sing this song to you. It goes like this, the fourth, the fifth, the minor fall and the major lift. With every breath I'm singing hallelujah. couple came to Bethlehem, expecting child. They searched the inn to find a place, for you were coming soon. There was no room for them to stay, so in a manger filled with hay, God's only son was born. Oh, hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. The shepherds left their flocks by night to see this baby wrapped in light. A host of angels led them all to you. It was just as the angel said, you'll find him in a manger bed. Emmanuel and Savior, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Star shone bright up in the east. To Bethlehem the wise men three came many miles and journeyed long for you. And to the place in which you were, their frankincense and gold and myrrh they gave to you and cried out, hallelujah, hallelujah. Place God sent his son to show us grace, and I just want to praise him every day. It was just as the scripture said, you'll find him in a manger bed. God's only son was born. Oh, hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. I know you came to rescue me. This baby boy would grow to be a man and one day die for you and me. My sins would drive the nails in you. That rugged cross was my cross too. Still every breath you drew was hallelujah, 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 hallelujah.
As our Lord presents from Matthew chapter 10, his word, our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, approximately 32 years of age, has endued power upon his 12 disciples to heal the sick, cleanse the lepers, raise the dead, and cast out the devils. But he says something interesting not long before he goes to that cruel cross to them. He says, go not into the way of the Gentiles. And that's exactly what you and I, who stand and sit here tonight, are. We are the Gentiles. I find it strange that this Christ child, grown into a man, the Son of God in the flesh, would say, go not by way of the Gentiles, but go rather to the lost sheep of the house of Israel. The power of God's word to issue forth the verbal, plenarily, God-breathed word of God through men. For some 32 years earlier, found in Luke chapter 2, even though in Matthew chapter 10, our Savior says, go not by way of the Gentiles, the man Simeon that was just portrayed. The scripture says, and behold, there was a man in Jerusalem whose name was Simeon, and the same man was just and devout, waiting for the consolation of Israel, and the Holy Ghost was upon him. And it's interesting to note that the Holy Ghost coming upon him is exactly the way God did his business prior to the death, burial, and resurrection of Jesus Christ. You see, today, those of us who have trusted Jesus Christ as God in the flesh, as our Savior, as we have trusted him, the Holy Ghost indwells these living temples that we have. We take him everywhere with us. He says, I will not leave you. I will not forsake him. If you truly possess him, then you truly possess him for all of eternity. And the interesting thing that Simeon prophesizes, and it was revealed unto him by the Holy Ghost that he should not see death before he had seen the Lord's Christ. And he came by the Spirit into the temple. And when the parents brought in the child Jesus to do for him after the custom of the law, then took him up in his arms and blessed God and said, Lord, now lettest thy servant depart in peace according to thy word, for mine eyes have seen thy salvation. Salvation, my friends, comes to us in no other way other than in the form of Jesus Christ. Salvation comes not to us by our goodness, not by how much we put in an offering plate, not how much we tithe or give to a church, but it comes to our hearts after the Holy Spirit knocks on our heart's door and we trust the only true salvation, Jesus Christ. Simeon says, for mine eyes have seen thy salvation, which thou hast prepared before the face of all people. And it's interesting to note his prophecy as he holds this little baby up in the temple. He says, a light to lighten the Gentiles. Some 32 years before Jesus told his own disciples, go not by way of the Gentiles, Simeon, an old man, prophesied what you and I benefit tonight. A light to lighten the Gentiles and the glory of thy people Israel. And Joseph and his mother marveled at those things which were spoken of him. And Simeon blessed them and said unto Mary his mother, another piece of prophecy. Behold, this child is set for the fall. And oh, did he fall. He was nailed to a cruel cross. He was buried in a tomb. But the good thing that Simeon prophesied of, and rising again. And he did just that. That's the greatest gift you and I could have tonight, because it's a gift that keeps on giving for all of eternity. He goes on to tell Mary, yea, a sword shall pierce through thine own soul also, that the thoughts of many hearts may be revealed. But this child that was set for the fall and the rising, and for a sign which shall be spoken against. All over this world tonight, this is a sign that is spoken against. Against. It would be my prayer tonight that there would be nobody within the sound of my voice that would speak against this gift in their heart tonight, but they would receive the greatest gift of all. I'm going to ask you to take your hymnals with me and turn to page 85. I'm going to ask you to stand. And as we close, I will tell you that the cast, of which I am so thankful for, and I'm thankful for their servitude to the Lord for what they have done, will be in the vestibule. You may avail yourself to them to stop and thank them, give them your thoughts, and I pray that this has been a blessing to each and every one of you tonight. And if you would sing the first and last verse with me before we close of Silent Night.
Silent night, holy night, all is calm, all is bright, round yon virgin mother and child, holy infant so tender and mild, sleep in heavenly peace, sleep in heavenly peace. Silent night, holy night, Son of God, love's pure light, radiant beams from thy holy face, with the dawn of redeeming grace, Jesus, Lord, at thy birth, Jesus, Lord, at thy birth.
Would you please join me in bowing your heads and closing your eyes as we take this time to close in prayer. Our Heavenly Father, Lord, again tonight as we come before you, I pray that you're pleased for what your eyes has beheld. I pray that the prayers of the saints in this house have been as a sweet-smelling savor as the frankincense that was burned in the temple. I pray that the myrrh, Lord, that was given to prepare your body for burial as Nicodemus brought to your death. I pray that our hearts understand that even those gifts, gold for a king, frankincense to represent the purity of the flame, during the evening oblations when the saints, the prayers of the saints were lifted up to you. Lord, the myrrh to prepare your body for the grave. I pray that each and every gift is reflected upon and we see that those gifts were for each and every one of us tonight. Our precious Heavenly Father, it's in the name of Jesus Christ, the only Lord and Savior, that I ask that as you endued power upon your disciples, that now you endow your blessings upon the family of God in this house. And Lord, should there be someone here tonight that perhaps may say, oh Lord, I've not walked with you. May they know, Lord, that if they've truly come to you, you will not leave them, you will not forsake them. And Lord, as the prodigal son, you're ready to kill the fatted calf and put the ring on their finger and give them that holy kiss on the neck. Father, I just pray your blessings upon the families of everyone represented here tonight. May we leave this house with a renewed spirit in the Holy Spirit of God. And it is in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost that I ask the blessings upon each and every one of you this Christmas season. Amen. Thank you and good night.
Thank you.
boy who came to earth to bring us joy. And I just want to sing this song to you. It goes like this, the fourth, the fifth, the minor fall and the major lift. With every breath I'm singing hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. A couple came to Bethlehem expecting child, they searched the inn to find a place, for you were coming soon. There was no room for them to stay, so in a manger filled with hay, God's only son was born. Oh, hallelujah, hallelujah. Shepherds left their flocks by night to see this baby wrapped in light. A host of angels led them all to you. It was just as the angel said, you'll find him in a manger bed. Emmanuel and Savior, hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. A star shone bright up in the east. To Bethlehem the wise men three came many miles and journeyed long for you. And to the place in which you were, their frankincense and gold and myrrh, they gave to you and cried out, hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Night and in this place, God sent his son to show us grace, and I just want to praise him every day. It was just as the scripture said, you'll find him in a manger bed. God's only son was born. Oh, hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. I know you came to rescue me. This baby boy would grow to be a man and one day die for you and me. My sins would drive the nails in you. That rugged cross was my cross too. Still every breath you drew